In this video, we're going to take a look at the concept of a subspace. We're actually going to be working with a polynomial vector space in this problem. So we're going to work with the vector space P3 specifically. We know what a vector space is. It's just a collection of objects. So in this case, the collection of objects is all polynomials of order 3. And the operations plus and scalar multiplication are just the typical operations that we use when working with polynomials. So we've defined the collection of objects, just sets of polynomials of order 3, the operations plus and the scalar multiplication operations. That's all we need to define a vector space. We've talked about polynomial vector spaces before, so we know that P3 is indeed a vector space. What we're going to work with here is we're going to work with the set of all polynomials of this form. So P of x equals ax cubed. So this includes just a subset of the polynomials in P3. Because remember, P3 includes polynomials of order 3. So even things like 1 plus 2 times x squared is part of this set, as is 1 plus 2x plus 9x cubed. That's also part of this vector space. What we've done here is we've restricted ourselves to just polynomials of this form, so they can only contain an x cubed term times a scalar number a from the reals. So this set right here of all possible ax cubes is much smaller than the elements in the vector space P3. Our question is this set of polynomials, px equals ax cubed, is this a subspace of P3? To determine if it's a subspace, I need to check just three things. So I'm already working with a vector space P3. I know P3 is a vector space, and I've chosen a subset of elements from it, this subset right here. Because of that, instead of having to check all 10 vector space axioms to establish that this new set is a vector space, I only need to check three things. I need to check that our subspace contains the zero vector, I need to check that it's closed under addition, and I need to check that it is closed under scalar multiplication. If it has these three properties, then this set is a subspace of the vector space P3, and since it's a subspace, it's itself a vector space. All the other properties, the other 7 properties that we won't check explicitly, those are all inherited from P3 in a trivial way that we don't even need to check for. So let's go ahead and see if this set of polynomials of the form ax cubed for arbitrary values of a in the reals is indeed satisfying these three properties. So let's go through them one by one. So first of all, does this collection of vectors contain the zero vector? Note that I get to choose any value that I want in A. So for all A in the reals, that means I can let A equal 0. So that means that my set contains the polynomial P of x equals 0. This is one of the vectors in this set. That means that for any P of x that I want to choose, so for some arbitrary P of x in my set, if you want to think of that as bx cubed or 1.2x cubed or a2x cubed, I can add 0 to it and end up back where I started. So this element, P of x equals 0, satisfies exactly the 0 property that I need. Any arbitrary P of x that I choose, when I add this 0 element to it, I get back where I started. So this is part of the set, and it satisfies the 0 property, so I can put a checkbox by the 0 vector property. What about being closed under addition? Let's choose two arbitrary polynomials from the set that I'm working with. So let's choose a1x cubed and a2x cubed. So these are both elements of my set, and I've chosen them very arbitrarily, letting a1 be an arbitrary number and a2 be an arbitrary number from the reals. Let's see what happens when I add them together. So let's compute a1x cubed plus a2x cubed. Well, if I add those together, I get a1 plus a2x cubed, and this looks like just another element from my set. Right? My set is of the form ax cubed for all values a. Well, this just looks like another value a right here. It matches up right there. So when I add two arbitrary polynomials from my set, I end up with another element from my set. So that means that I am closed under vector addition. And finally, let's check to see if I'm closed under scalar multiplication. If I choose an arbitrary element from my set, I'm going to call it a1x cubed, so I've chosen some arbitrary number a1, and let's also choose some arbitrary scalar from the reals, I'm just going to call it b. what happens if I multiply this scalar times my vector? Well, I'm going to get b times a1x cubed. And again, this is an element of my set of polynomials x cubed because I have a number times x cubed. Well, my set consists of all polynomials of the form ax cubed, so the number ba1 is in the set of reals. So this is closed under scalar multiplication as well. So for this subspace, I'm working with a set of polynomials taken from a larger set of polynomials. I have a subset. I've shown that it has a zero vector element. It satisfied this property. I've shown that arbitrary elements selected from my set when added together yield another element from my set, so it's closed under addition. And I've also shown that when I choose an arbitrary element from my set and multiply by an arbitrary scalar, I end up with another element from my set, so I'm closed under scalar multiplication. So having satisfied these three properties, we know that the set of polynomials in this problem is indeed a subspace of P3.